And we're ready to go. Back with Hot Shots Golf, and this time it is at the Road in China, the February tournament. First matchup is Misaki versus Tiff. We'll start on the second hole. Par three.
Roger that one. Be the ball.
Not bad. That's not bad, 11 feet. I know Tiff can beat that, so this could be bad for her. 12.1, that's not half bad.
That ball is your enemy. Useless one.
She's put it in. Well, Misaki's got to do the same thing. She didn't. That would have been a tie hole. Yeah, it would have been a tie hole because they would have both got 220 points. Remember, points count, too. So Tiff trying to get the easy win. Knock Misaki out right at the frickin' bat. As it were. She botched that shot. Sometimes when you think you've got a chance to win a full, you blow it, it ruins your chances. It ruins your confidence. Dev can just go up and under. She missed, but she didn't hit the sand trap, which gives her a couple of whole of strokes to play with. Misaki is gonna roll it.
Well done.
Now Tiff's got this one. Man, one bad putt can ruin you.
Running laps.
Well, Tiff. Well, this one. Poor Misaki. She took second last. She took second. Well, we're back with two new golfers. It's Zed versus Regis. It's Zed, the powerful robot, wins his match against Regis. He gets a guaranteed spot. Well, he'll face Tiff. Because that will be a mess. Good? Ooh, not bad. He just says, I gotta take a gamble here. He's on the green, that's a fairway, excuse me, that's 20 points. That's a decent shot, 10 feet away. Oh, he didn't set up his thing.
Okay. Don't let me down!
Don't let me down, Bruce! Oh, it would not have mattered anyway. No. Regis made his birdie putt. So technically, I know they said, well, wait a minute, Zed's didn't take the right club. Technically, it would not have mattered because even if he hit that 20-foot putt, Regis had his 10-foot putt. It was closer, so it was on the green. I mean, fairway. So technically, you have nothing to worry about. Reach. position which you don't want to be in. It didn't seem like a good shot, but now what do you do here? You gotta chip yourself out. And we were about to say, just when you think Regis has this one all wrapped up. Well, there might be hope for the pup, because said lure. That freaking sand trap. To tie up the batch, yes.
Might be art.
Nice. It isn't fair. Regis with the, well, she's facing God with a better one width. So, he's out. And now we got Cabela and Emma facing each other. Forgot to add that Misaki was the first winner at Silk Road in 2015. Since the new format came into play. So, I don't know, she's gone. Kudo's the only other winner here in China. So he'll be up, coming up later on in the day. Oh, that's one advantage of not having a lot of distance off the tee with your best things, because that actually gives Emma a chance. 20 points. And Emma? What? Are you joking me? How the hell did you do that?
Your shirt's going in. Don't get talking.
Wow. Unfreaking believable. That has got to be the best second shot I've seen in this tournament in nearly a year. Holy smokes. How did you do that? It's a bamboo tree, but remember, you can hit a tree. And it won't penalize you. It kind of does penalize you. Cabela's like, I'm going to win this match. Probably. But she won't win this hole. Emma's got a 2-foot putt for Ego.
I hunt bald eagles. London eagles.
Great job by Eva with the eagle. Emma's going to take it a little easy here. You don't want too much off the green, because you want to hit the fairway. Because the fairway, remember, is 10 points. Chocolate thunder sauce. Well, that was a mistake. I think she got a little antsy-pantsy. Well, let's see what her second shot brings. Pain. Is off the green. That's not bad, not bad.
Well done.
Great chip chop. She could do a chip in. Ah, she would have had that hole. Oops. Actually, no, Camilla would have had it anyway. Alright, that's fine. Camilla had the hole anyway.
The last hole is lost.
Another part five. Gotta go two part fives. And the question on everyone's lips is, when you do that, do you go for it or not? In all honesty, I would go around. That's what I do. I go around. Besides, you are down by a stroke. That's the plan. That's the plan. Just go around. Because you're not risking anything. That's your time. Well, that looks good.
And you are a pro. Alright.
Careful.
Like stealing a quail egg. It's on the...
Oh, what a putt!
Just relax.
Oh, she had the match. She had the match right in her hands and she missed that easy. And next on this list, you'll see Mel and Chaos picking each other up. Mel is the only one of the 24 golfers who's never been to a final in the first 2 years of this format.
Oh!
Oh, he got it. Well, we're ready to go. It's Mike and Lynn facing off. Lynn, of course, has been the national hero of China. A lot of people were putting signs calling for me. Jingai Norai Tika. I don't know, I think Lynn may have screwed herself up with her angle.
Yeah.
Nice job. She got on the green.
That ball is your enemy. Useless one.
Did you say green tea gives you green pee? Good shot.
Bury that ball.
Looks good. No.
If you miss, you're running laps.
This to face Kamala. Nice. Beautiful. Well, we're ready to go with this next matchup. It's Mike, it's Tony and Seuss battling each other. Of course, Tony would be named the comeback player of the year for 2016 because of his crappiness in 2015, not winning a first round match until September. And then all of a sudden he wins a tournament. Oof. Well, that was quick. Tony gets a quick one up on Seuss. That's the best thing you can do, is just set up your third shot decently. Seuss is on the green.
And we'll putt first. Put this in. I might use them up here.
This is not an easy putt.
Whoa!
What did he?
Come on!
What a shot! He can't. So Seuss wins that hole, and we are going to another one.
I've never been married.
said, well, I can't believe this shot. Ah, Tony. How did he match that one?
Maybe I should go back in.
Just one. Sean? Yeah. Oh, here comes T-Bone, who won last year in China. He faces Maya. So, anyway, Zeus plays Mel, by the way. So you got Lynn versus Camilla. Nice shot. I hope the bridge doesn't affect your second shot. Get back the tree. I didn't even overshoot that. I hope it doesn't hit the bridge. I didn't. How did he end up dunking it? On my cookie. I think for T-Bone the best way is to go around, but we'll see what happens. See if he has an angle. Well, he's gonna go for it. As well. Oh, how did he do that? Well, Maya says if he can do it, I can too. Nope. She figured he was gonna choke. Look at. She figured he was gonna choke on that hole. So, regardless, we're on to the next hole. Not bad.
You're in the front tower.
You didn't look clean.
Look those wings.
13.
I have a parakeet.
Got it.
Give it up, Bobby. I know you can do this.
You better make the shot. He does. Oh, I thought he was close to the pin, giving him the win.
I don't like this one thing.
Neither do I. T-Bone, not bad, 22 feet. Sometimes on a par three, it's actually better to check and see if you got to see what the angle is. See?
You're the bird on the nest.
He's got it. Whoa!
Who wants a trophy?
This one. So we'll see a first time winner here at Silk Road. As Maya just put it in. Well, we're doing pretty well. We got Renee and Louise battling each other for this matchup. If Renee wins, she takes on Maya. If Louise wins, she'll wait a little bit to see who her first or second round opponent will be.
It's not a day for skirts.
No kidding. See what Louise, I mean, Renee does. That.
You're on the island.
And Chinese sand is a whole lot different than
that
the other
is
sand.
Because
of the color. I think she's okay because technically she's got like two strokes. Good shot. For the hole. What we've noticed in China is that, well, the two finalists from January, Emma and Misaki, both fumbled in the first round, so never mind the jinx that whoever wins the previous tournament usually doesn't do well in the other tournament. Forgot to also mention that Jack, of course, is the defending two-time Super 12s champion. He'll go last. That's just the way it sets up. It's random how they... Wait.
Roger that one.
Maybe that was not the best angle. Oh, that would have been a nice bogey.
Well done.
Oof. That insult to injury. Penalized by dropping a golf club.
You're on the island. Here you are.
Closer?
That ball is your enemy. It left a beat.
Probably not. Got it. Yes.
Sweet.
Well, it's my turn.
If you miss it, you lose.
She can't afford to lose this one. And she does.
I hate losing.
Okay. Man, she had the hole. She had the match. She had the match because of the points, but she blew it. Well, here we are. The last four matches here at Silk Road. First up, we have Falcon versus Hubert. If Falcon wins, he'll take on Maya. Falcon is the last of the three finalists from Wild Wild West to actually in the competition. The other two finalists didn't qualify for the second round, so... I don't know what you think. So anyway, Falcon is in the Super 12s already because he's won an event. So he... But of course you're playing for points and you're playing for like positioning. That could determine what will happen. So birdie from 33 away. Oh she! Falcon, that looks good! Oh she! Good grief, they both had great birdie putts. And they both missed. That is a draw. So nothing good about that. Falcon's point of view. Hubert wins his matchup number 6, which means that he'll wait a little bit to see who his second round opponent will be. The first second round is big because that's 6 holes instead of 3. Hubert played a bad shot. I don't know what Hubert was thinking on the 4th, but anyway, looks like Falcon will have this match. Signed, sealed, and delivered? Who knows? Short, 282. Huber, nice job, 284. Now, the question on everyone's lips will be, can they get up over those bamboo trees? He can, but he hit the water. Dock it. Oh, jeez. How the heck did Huber get that in this shot? Falcon said I might as well just continue. Yeah, you would have had it too. Yeah, he's like, that would have got him an advantage, but... So, we go to extras. Just missed. Falcon knows that if he can get on the fairway, it's 1 point. Yes. That's 20 points that he's got in his hands. Oh, she... Falcon to keep going. Yes, sir.
Let's talk about me more.
We will in the second round.
Sword for your head.
And now, we have Alan and Sam facing each other. Alan would love to face Louise in the next round. Sam, if he wins, he's in matchup number 6. This is not the easy one. It's the island one. Go across one island. Yeah. Nice. Nice.
You're the first Alice. You're the bird on the nest.
Oh, yeah.
Tell your parents all about that.
Man, that would have been embarrassing if you missed that chunk. Sounded like she said something else. Sam's height was actually was more than 10 feet. He missed anyway.
Are you a stranger?
That was gutsy, and he put it down. Aww. Well, he got it out. Oh, he thought he was good. He's like, yes, all I gotta do is stay dry.
Did he use a shovel?
He's gotta put this down. Oof. Yes, he does. Well, he couldn't do it.
Thanks, Goosey.
Alright, so we have this big matchup between Brad and Ratchet in the first round. The winner of this matchup faces Phoebe or Jack. It's been decided.
Thank you.
Brad. Nice. Nicely done. Oh, that just ruined his day. He's out.
Son of a
bitch! I did it anything. Well, we are ready to go. It's Phoebe and Jack. Winner takes on Brad in the next round of the competition. If Phoebe beats Jack, then she gets a bonus point no matter what she does. Because that bonus point is for being the defending Super 12 champion. Jack, I'm a little too in that one. Can Phoebe sweep him? Looks good. Feels good.